And if we don't accept that today, we are in a very big blind spot of glaucoma. And that blind spot will lead us into an undistinctive future. Think about it. An average African can stand up and fight with his government to say that you are damn corrupt. And that's what's common with the average Indian who stood up and told the government, down with the government which is corrupt. Awareness. And they did that with a fair amount of regime to believe that they can translate that broad vision into action. Because they realized vision with action can actually change the world. It can physically change the world. And each time they came up with that paradigm to translate that vision into action, they believed what they wanted to do was to reach out. And they reached out to people far more positively together and made an impact. And it knows it must run faster than the slowest lion or it will be eaten to death. It does not matter whether you're the lion or the gazelle. When the morning is up, keep running, keep running, keep running. Remember I told you running, very important. So we need to keep running. How many of you feel life is a rat race and you're running it all the time? Put your hands up. Many of you. Just keep running. Okay, that's enough. My story number three and the last story. This story is very impactful. I draw inspiration for the story from my friends in South Africa. And the story goes like this. There was once a very famous author. He was very fond of writing books. So every day in the morning, he would wake up. He would walk by the seaside, go back to his cottage and continue writing. He produced some of the best sellers in the world. His name is Dr. Joel Barker, and he's a futurist. J-O-E-L-B-A-R-K-E-R, Joel Barker. He's a futurist. He created the word called paradigm, paradigm, paradigms. One day, as he's walking by the seaside, from a distance he sees a human figure dancing. He wonders to himself, why should anybody be dancing? The sun is up, it's going to get warmer by the day. Suddenly he gets curious. He walks up to this human figure. He sees it's a young man. He looks at this young man and says, young man, why are you dancing? The young man says, can't you see I'm not dancing? I'm picking up starfish and putting it back into the sea. But young man, there are miles and miles of starfish. You can't save all of them. To which the young man says, the one which is in my hand, when I put it against the dashing waves, it makes a difference to this one. The response surprises the author. That night he cannot sleep. The next day in the morning, he wakes up and along with the young man, he starts throwing starfish into the sea. The moral of the story, if you throw your stars wisely and well, the future is yours. If you cannot throw your stars wisely and well, you don't have a future. The choice is entirely yours. The last video, please. ...of the world's payments by mobile phone happen in South Africa, for your information. 67%. Of the world's e-payments happen in South Africa. There's a lot to say on that regard. And therefore, you're right, you're completely right. The highest mobile innovations were recorded in China by the World Mobile Congress that happens in Barcelona every year. 32,000 mobile innovations in a year. And the person who gave the youngest mobile innovation is 15 and a half years of age, a Chinese boy who got $3.5 million worth of investment by a US VC funding company. It's a paradox. It's a complete paradox. So what you see and what you're going to see, predominantly young populations, where the populations are very young, are going to translate every innovation and own them. After China, 16,000 innovations in mobility or in mobile was recorded in India. And out of 16,000, 12,000 were funded by the US VC funders. How do you like that? There's just nothing you can do. Just nothing you can do. Of the most fundamental thing in a relationship would be that a relationship of a mentor and a protege. So coach. Coach as much as you can the generations to come. And if you're able to coach the generations to come, the mindset change occurs easily. Remember, values guide us through difficult times. When we lose our values, there's everything that we lose, because in uncertain times, values will guide us. To answer your second question, your daughter does not have enough physical activity. I'm really sorry to be blunt, but you're responsible for it. You stop jumping, you stop running, you stop playing, and that's why you get old. Reinvent the wheel and start playing. Reinvent the wheel with your daughter. Find time to play. Find time to hold her hand and say, darling, let's run together, let's jump together, let's go to the garden together. But you're not doing it enough.
May I?
Please.
One of the runners for the marathon was myself. And I'm very happy to say that my daughter will be joining me for 3 kilometers.
So then you don't have a problem.
But her friends or herself also, it's not as much as I would like. Maybe I'm over-expecting, I don't know.
Okay. But for the sake of this room, please don't record me. Please don't quote me. Stop going to McDonald's. Stop going to KFC. Eat more greens at home. Cultivate that habit of change in diet, and you will find a lot of changes. And I can tell you with a lot of imaginative approach that the whole thing needs creativity. Our creativity is dying. It's completely dying. And because we are responsible for killing it. So if you want to enhance our creativity and renew it, I think there's some need for renewal from within. When you don't have answers to a lot of questions in life, you leave it to spirituality and say God will take care. But God helps those who want to help themselves.